Hey guys, Ollie from flightcomp, and I'm back. Gonna make a short video, yet another Vertigo build tip video, because we have a tiny little update in some of the parts that come with the kit, and it has to do with the wiring harness for the wing and the fuselage. Basically, we get DB9 connectors that come with the kit, which is the same as what it previously had. But on the fuselage side, GCM has actually had this circuit board made up, and it comes pre-soldered to the fuselage side of the fuselage DB9 connector here. And these connectors are a little different than the regular DB9 connectors, because they're pin connectors. They're not the open receptacle on the back. They're just like little needles sticking up. So if you were to try to get one of these circuit boards, you'd have to make sure you get the right DB9 connector too. But anyway, so what this does is, this goes in the fuselage, like this. Obviously it mounts in here, it goes in like this. And you solder the fuselage side wire for the harness onto this end of the circuit board, and you bring the wire in from the top side and do a little bit of soldering on the bottom. So basically you'll have all your wire coming off like this. And this, in conjunction with another part, let me just grab that now. In conjunction with this part, is going to keep all the wire in your fuselage off the floor of the fuselage pod, and it's going to keep the area under your wing saddle and up to the shoulder of the fuselage completely clear of wire, so that when you go to put ballast in, you're not going to hit or snag any of the wire. Obviously, my original models that I flew were just standard wiring harnesses, and I was always fighting the wire harness in there, trying to get the ballast in, and I was always worried about damaging the wire and the wire harness. But with these parts, it just makes it 10 times easier. It's really a breeze to put in. So how this works is, here's the receiver tray, which is a little different than the older receiver tray. And it basically gets glued in like this. And your receiver sits on top here. And then this guy, when it's installed, will look something like this. So it'll be like right here. And then you'll have your wire coming up going to the receiver. So none of the wire is going to drop below this plate. And it's just going to make putting ballast in really easy. And that's what this was designed for, is basically making ballast changes really quick and easy. So I'm just going to go over how to solder this up and how to get it going, because there is actually a little printing error on the circuit board with the number, so you have to keep that in mind. But once I explain it to you, you'll see how easy it is. So let's get going. Okay, I'm going to start off doing the wire harnesses on this Vertigo by doing the center panel first. And I've just taped on this bit of cardboard here. You can see I made a split down the middle, and I cut a hole here, and then I have the wires coming out, and this is just going to protect the wing when I'm soldering and working on the connector. I've already gone ahead and tinned all the wires. I have the reds connected together, so both the reds coming from this side are connected together. Same with the negative, so positive and negative. I did the same thing on this side. And then I just tinned up the signal wires. So now we got to solder on the connector. It can be a little bit tricky working in here, but with this cardboard on here, it should help us out a lot. I'm going to start out by soldering on the negative leads, which are going to be 6 and 9. So we have 6, 7, 8, 9. We're going to be using these outer pins, and I've connected everything together and transferred that with the black marker you can see there. So we'll be soldering onto this post and this post. So the negatives are soldered on. I did put some small bits of heat shrink on first. Next thing I'm going to do is solder on the middle pins, which are 7 and 8, and those are going to be both of the positive leads. Positives and negatives are done and soldered. Got a little bit of heat shrink tubing on there. I'm going to move on to doing the signal wires, and I'm going to do it the way that GCM recommends. They actually gave me like a recommended order. So it's going to be one right aileron, two right flap, three left flap, five left aileron, and those numbers correspond to the numbers on the circuit board. And here's where the error in the circuit board comes in. If we look at the circuit boards, you can see that there's numbers on the connector side and there's numbers on the wire harness side. Then we can see the traces on the circuit board. So you can follow the traces, you know, one should connect to one, two should connect to two, six to six, eight to eight, etc., etc. And that's all the case except for actually four connects to three. So four is written on the front of the board, and three is written on the back of the board. And by front, I mean where the wire connects, and back is where the DB9 connector connects. So if you try to connect four to four or three to three, you're going to scratch your head. But if you actually just follow the trace, you'll see that 4 goes to 3. So again, 1 to 1 is right aileron, 2 to 2, right flap, 4 to 3, left flap, 5 to 5, left aileron. The rest, of course, are positive and negatives. So let's go ahead and solder on the signal wires. All the soldering is done. Soldering, depending on where you live. And I just got to pull some of these wires through a little bit. So out here, I've just taped the end of the wire to the end of the wing, and there's no connector on it. So I'm just going to pull the aileron wires a little bit and suck up some of that wire there, and then I'll go in the flap bay and pull those wires a little bit too, and then we'll try to stuff this in here and screw it down. Alright, I pulled the wires through, and you can see this is kind of sucked in a little bit, and we can push it in place and screw it down. And I have put it in place and drilled a couple of holes. I don't know if you can see those there. I used a 1.5 millimeter drill bit, and then I'm going to use some really small like servo hold down screws. They're about, I don't know, maybe 5 or 6 millimeters long, and we're going to screw that connector down. Connector is screwed in, and I'll give you one of my little secrets or tips that I always do is I don't tighten these screws completely tight, so there's a little bit of play in this connector. It's not loose, but there's just a little bit of play, so when you plug in the fuselage, if things are misaligned a little bit, that play will help relieve stress and keep things plugged in nicely. So that's it. Let's move on to the fuselage side harness. All right, I've cut up some of the wire that's included with the kit, and I've tinned the ends very lightly. You don't want to get big blobs on there because they have to go through these holes, and I'm just going to start pushing them through in the corresponding holes. And again, they're going to come in from the top, and I'm going to solder them from the bottom. All right, so I have soldered on the wires to the board. As you can see, I inserted them from the top and soldered on the bottom. And I had a lot of wire exposed, and I just went in and clipped them off with a pair of flush cutters. So we have a very low profile here on the wires. I've also put some silicone around the wires on the bottom side just to help protect and for some strain relief. And this is basically done. I have also crimped on the servo connectors on this side. If you don't know how to crimp on connectors or you're not comfortable doing it, you can just get some lightweight extensions that are, you know, the right length, and just cut off the ends and then strip the wire and solder them on there. The last thing I'm going to do to this is just, I'm going to put a real thin coat of 5 or 15 minute epoxy over these joints just to protect the bottom edges. So in case any ballast or metal or anything comes in contact with this, it won't short. And then that'll be it. Okay, we're all done with this little fuselage harness. You can see my blobs of epoxy protecting the back of the joints there. And this is ready to go into the fuselage. Just a reminder, this is the front of the tray, and this is going to sit in here about like this, or maybe like this. And all the wire is going to go above the tray, and your receiver is going to sit in here on top. If you need to know how to install this tray here, I already did a video on this. It is the older tray, but it's the same installation, so you can just look in the Vertigo build videos. I think I made a playlist, and you can see the video on how to install this tray. Alright guys, I hope you found this video useful, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.